गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस एनोमलस बिहेवियर ऑफ वाटर, ट्रिपल पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर एंड हीट ट्रांसफर, इन विच देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स, कंडक्शन, कन्वेक्शन एंड रेडिएशन। नाउ एनोमलस बिहेवियर ऑफ वाटर। इन जनरल व्हेन अ लिक्विड इज हीटेड अप टू अ सर्टन टेम्परेचर इट एक्सपांड्स एंड व्हेन कूल इट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स। Water, however, shows a special and exceptional behavior. If we heat water from 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius, it contracts instead of expanding. At 4 degree Celsius, its volume is minimum due to contraction. If the water is heated further, it expands and its volume increases. The behavior of water between its temperature from 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius is called anomalous behavior of water. If we consider water at 0 degree Celsius and starting heated, okay, from 0 to 4 degree Celsius, see, the volume initially decreases up to 4 degree Celsius and then increases beyond 4 degree Celsius. Okay, so this means that the density increases from 0 to 4 degree Celsius and then also decreases. See, at 4 degree Celsius, the density is highest density of water at 4 degree Celsius. Okay, students. Anomalous behavior of water has an important environmental effect for the survival of aquatic plants and animals in ponds and lakes. The lakes and ponds, the top water freezes first. The lake cools towards 4 degree Celsius. Water near the surface loses energy to the atmosphere, becomes denser and sinks. The warmer and less dense water near the bottom rises up. However, once colder water on the top reaches temperature below 4 degree Celsius, it becomes less dense and remains at the top where it freezes. So the layer of ice at the top of the water acts as bad conductor of heat. Therefore, water below the ice layer remains at 4 degree Celsius even if the temperature of the environment lower below 4 degree Celsius. And 4 degree Celsius water is sufficient for the survival of aquatic plants and animals in the water. Right, students? And now, triple point of water. See, this is the phase diagram of water. Let us try to understand the phase diagram. See, there are three curves: LS curve, LV curve, and SV curve. The first curve, that is vaporization curve, LV. LV represents those points where the liquid and water vapor phases are in equilibrium. Thus, it is a graph of boiling point versus pressure. Note that the curve correctly shows that at a pressure of 1 atmosphere, the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, as shown in figure. देखिए स्टूडेंट, ये जो एल वी कर्व है, यहाँ पर क्या होता है कि लिक्विड एंड वाटर वेपर, ओके, बोथ एग्जिस्ट, को एग्जिस्ट साइमल्टेनियसली. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज वेपराइजेशन कर्व, एल वी. नाउ सेकंड कर्व इज फ्यूजन कर्व, दैट इज डिनोटेड बाय एल एस. द कर्व एल एस रिप्रेजेंट्स द पॉइंट्स वेयर द सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड फेजेस को एग्जिस्ट इन वाटर, okay, in equilibrium. Thus, it is a graph of freezing point versus pressure. At one standard atmospheric pressure, the freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius, as shown in figure. Also notice that at a pressure of one standard atmosphere, water is in liquid phase if the temperature is between 0 degree Celsius and 100 degree Celsius, but is in the solid or vapor phase if the temperature is below 0 degree Celsius or above 100 degree Celsius. Note that LS curve, that is liquid solid curve for water, slopes upward to the left, that is fusion curve of water has slightly negative slope. This is true only of the substance that expands upon freezing. However, for most materials like carbon dioxide, LS curve shows upward to the right, that is fusion curve has positive slope. The melting point of carbon dioxide is minus 56 degrees Celsius at higher pressure of 5.11 atmosphere. Dear students, the third curve, that is sublimation curve, denoted by SV. The curve labeled SV, that is solid vapor, okay, is the sublimation point versus pressure curve. Water sublimates at pressure less than 0.006 atmosphere. There are certain substances like copper, which normally passes from the solid to the vapor state directly, and vice versa. The change from solid state to vapor state without passing through the liquid state is called sublimation, and the substance is said to be sublime. Dry ice and iodine are sublime. Triple point. Dear student, what is the definition of triple point? The temperature and pressure at which fusion curve, the vaporization curve, and sublimation curve meet, and all the three phases of substance coexist, is called triple point of that substance. That is, the triple point of water is that point where water in solid, liquid, and gaseous states coexist in equilibrium. And this occurs only at a unique temperature and pressure. The triple point of water is 273.16 Kelvin, that is 0.01 degree Celsius, and 6.11 into 10 raised to minus 3 Pascal, that is 0.006 atmospheric pressure. Right, students? This is the phase diagram for triple point of carbon dioxide. Okay, that of carbon dioxide is minus 56.6 degree Celsius. ये इसका triple point temperature, student. And pressure कितना है यहाँ पर? 5.11 into 10 raised to minus 5 Pascal. Or 5.11 atmospheric pressure. Right, student? Dear students, now heat transfer. We know that heat always transfer from hot body to cold body. There are three types of heat transfer: conduction, convection, and radiation. See, dear students, conduction is a slow process. Thermal conduction is the process in which heat is transferred from hot end to cold end without actual migration of molecules or atoms of medium. It requires material medium. Heat passes through solids by conduction only. If a steel rod is held at one end and other end is placed in Bunsen flame, it is observed that very soon the rod becomes warm at the other end. It means that heat flows from hot end to cold end of the rod. In this case, the molecules of the rod do not move from their positions, but the heat travels from hotter to colder part. This process of transmission of heat is called conduction. See, student, solids and all types of metals are good conductors of heat. Now, in metals or solids, the molecules or atoms are compactly arranged. So, it is useful to transfer the heat by conduction easily. Moreover, there are free electrons, which are also useful to conduct the heat energy through the solids very rapidly. See, when heat is given to the metal rod, the electrons absorb heat energy and collides with other electrons and also with the other molecules and atoms.
and therefore rapidly that heat conducted by molecules to molecules and electrons to onwards. But in case of gas, the distance between molecules is so large, so there is not possible to transfer heat by conduction. So gases, airs are bad conductors of heat. Right, student? In liquid, the molecules are more separated than the solid. So negligible conduction takes place in solids. Conductivity of liquid is greater than gaseous. But in generally, liquid ho ya gas ho, that conduction is not possible through fluids. Okay, dear students. Wood, backlight, wool are bad conductors of heat energy. So they are used as insulators. Cooking utensils are made up of metals with handles of bad conductor. For example, wood, ebonite, etc. Here, heat can be easily conducted through metals, as metals are good conductor of heat. Bad conductors will not conduct the heat from utensil to our hand. For cooking utensils, in car radiator and nuclear power plant, good conductors are used. Okay, dear students, now second mode of heat transfer is convection. What is convection? The definition is, convection of heat is defined as the process of transfer of heat through a material medium in which the particles of the medium carry thermal energy from the higher temperature region to lower temperature region. That means there is actual migration of particles from higher region temperature to lower temperature region. Right, students? When the beaker containing water is placed on a burner, the water at the bottom and above the flame is the first to receive heat, as a result which it expands and its density decreases. This water thus becomes lighter and moves upward and is replaced by the heavier water situated above and around it. This water is in turn heated, it expands, its density decreases, and it moves upward. Okay, in this way, this cycle goes on repeating so long as the water is being heated. The process of transfer of heat in this way is called convection of heat. Right, student? Dekhe, water jab heat absorb karta hai at the bottom, uski density kam ho jati hai, aur phir lighter water moves upward, and heavier water having higher density moves downward towards the bottom. So in this way, a current generates, that is transfer of heat, due to actual movement of water molecules from bottom to top and from top to bottom. Dekhe, from the bottom to the top, hot water moves up, and where from top to bottom, cold water moves downward. So in this way, the molecules as shown in figure moves from top to bottom, bottom to top. Convection is possible only in fluids, that is liquid and gaseous. Convection is more comparatively rapid process than conduction. See students, convections are of two types, natural convection and forced convection. Natural convection of free convections, when a hot body is in contact with air under ordinary conditions, like air around a firewood, air removes heat from the body by a process called free or natural convection. Land and sea bridges are also formed as a result of free convection current in air. Heating of water is also free convection. See student, the molecules, cold molecules move downward because of gravity, and hot molecules, because of its decreasing density, it moves upward. Suppose the heat is given at the top of the water, so convection is not possible here. Right, students? Land and sea bridges are also formed as a result of convections currents in air. During daytime, the land near the sea gets heated by the sun to a higher temperature than the sea. Due to greater heat capacity of water, the temperature of sea does not rise as much as that of the land. Also, due to mixing of hot surface layer with the colder layers below them, the temperature of sea is lower than that of the land. As a result of this, air above the land is heated to a higher temperature. It becomes lighter and rises upward. It is replaced by cooler air moving from the sea towards the land, and the sea bridge is set up. Sister, at the night, the condition is reverse. During night time, the land cools rapidly while owing to this, its greater heat capacity. Water takes longer time to cool. Therefore, the land is at lower temperature than the sea. The air above the sea is now hotter and lighter, and it moves upward to be replaced by the cooler air moving from the land to the sea. In this way, land bridge is set up at night. Now students, trade winds is also example of natural convection. Northeast and southeast trade winds. See student, the sunlight falls normally on the equator. So the air near the equator becomes hot, its density decreases, and it moves towards the cold part of the North Pole and South Pole. So in this way, the air blown, that means trade winds generated due to natural convection. Now students, second type, forced convection. That means the air is accelerated by using pump, blower, fan to create a rapid circulation of air. This is called forced convection. Example, dekhiye students, forced convection is taken place in hair dryer. Now in hair dryer, the cool air is taken in. Okay, there is one fan which accelerates the air at room temperature, and that air passes through the hot coil, and through the front nozzle that hot air is accelerated because of the fan. Okay student, in this way, this is the example of forced convection. Okay, the forced convection of blood in our body by a pump or heart helps in keeping the temperature of body constant. Dear students, third mode of heat transfer is radiation. The transfer of heat energy from one place to another via emission of electromagnetic energy in a straight line with the speed of light without heating the intervening medium is called radiation. Dear students, intervening medium ka matlab hota hai, the medium present between sun and earth, that is vacuum. So without heating the vacuum, that heat energy transfer from sun surface to earth surface. Okay, and this type of transfer of heat, that is radiation, is the fastest mode of heat transfer because the heat is transferred with the speed of light, that is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Okay students.